A middleweight bout here. Jamie Pickett back in action, sitting at plus 240 against Josh Fremd, who's coming in at minus 330. Over under 1.5 rounds, minus 170 for the over, plus 140 for the under. Jamie Pickett, 2-3 in his last five, 3-2 in his last five for Josh Fremd. 34 years of age for Jamie Pickett, 13-9 in his professional career. 80-inch reach for him, though. Couple of bigger guys. Josh Fremd, 6'4". Jamie Pickett got that long reach, sitting at 6'2". If you don't know the deal, you probably got to, you know, do your homework a little bit, but that's why you're here. Jamie Pickett, last time out, gets taken out by Bo Nickel, gets fed to the wolves in Bo Nickel, and he gets submitted in the first round. It's been a rough, I want to say a rough go about for him because, I mean, he got three shots on the contender series, losses to his first two, and then won the third one, gets a contract, comes in, loses two in a row, wins two in a row, and now he's lost three in a row. So I want to say up and down, but the ups haven't been great and the downs have been pretty bad. And we're coming in here against Josh Fremd, who got a big win in his last time out. I mean, lost his first two fights in the UFC and then gets a win against Dumas. Looked pretty good in that one, but he's coming in as a big favorite. What are you thinking?
I don't like the price, but I like Fremd here. I don't know, betting wise, like, it's just so, I don't even want to say low level, but there's so many unknowns with Fremd still. Like, he got the win over Dumas, but outside of that, like, you know, we saw him get knocked out or subbed by Treshawn Gore, about popped his head off. He loses to Anthony Hernandez. We really haven't seen him against the guy who, in Jamie Pickett, who, like, you know, he'll stuff some takedowns, will try to clinch and grapple with you as well. And on the feet, Jamie Pickett just doesn't impress anybody. I don't think he's ever landed more than 60 strikes in a fight. So he's lower volume. It's not really his game plan to go out there and get in these brawls with dudes and knock dudes out by any means. And Fremd, you know, I just feel like we got more to see from him. You know, beating Dumas was super impressive because a lot of people were hyped on Dumas because of the athleticism and the head kicks, knockouts he has and submissions. But he crashed that party pretty quick. He got a couple takedowns on Dumas, and you know, we all know how that went from there with the sub in the second round. I don't know how you pick Jamie Pickett at this point, just based off what we've seen from him. You know, knocked out by Dennis Tallulah, subbed by Kyle Daukaus, and then Bo Nickel obviously subbed him. But in the Bo Nickel fight, he did a pretty good job holding his own against the cage for a bit until he got kneed in the nuts and then taken down. You know, I'm not going to say I was super impressed with him, but he is a strong dude and he was able to hold himself up for a little bit and then had no answer, obviously, when he was off his back. So overall, I think Josh Fremd wins this fight, but the line's a little wide and crazy to even be confident when you're talking about these two types of fighters.
Yeah. I mean, like you said, I don't love the price, but it's like, how can you get behind Jamie Pickett?
Yeah.
I'm honestly surprised he's back with, another fight. I'm guessing maybe just because he took the Bo Nickel fight that they're like, you know, we'll get you one here, one more shot, and if you could pull it off, I don't know, maybe we'll keep you, maybe we'll cut you. But for Josh Fremd, he is still 29 years old, and he went to a decision with Anthony Hernandez on short notice too. I mean, that's tough to do. Like, Anthony Hernandez has been breaking guys ever since he fought Josh Fremd. So that kind of ages pretty well. The loss to Treshawn Gore does not. I mean, that was like just a bad performance, but comes out and gets a good win. He trains at a good camp. I don't love the price, but I think you got to go with him for the pick. So that's the way I'm going to go. Josh Fremd getting it done.
Yeah.
The submission skills. And, you know, Jamie Pickett was submitted his last time out. So,
yeah. I mean, think of it this way for Fremd. Like, Anthony Hernandez went out there and subbed Adolfo Vieira, Marc-Andre Barrio, and then knocked out Edmund Shahbazyan, and Josh Fremd was able to survive three rounds with him and even get one takedown of his own on him. So, you know, that's a little positive if you think of it in that light.